Genesis chapter 25, verses 27 to 34. The boys grew up, and Esau became a skillful hunter, a man of the open country, while Jacob was a quiet man, staying among the tents. Isaac, who had a taste for wild game, loved Esau, but Rebekah loved Jacob. Once, when Jacob was cooking some stew, Esau came from the open country, famished. He said to Jacob, "Quick, let me have some of that red stew. I'm famished." That is why he was also called Edom. Jacob replied, "First, sell me your birthright." "Look, I'm about to die," Esau said. "What good is the birthright to me?" But Jacob said, "Swear to me first." So he swore an oath to him, selling his birthright to Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau some bread and some lentil stew. He ate and drank, and then got up and left. So Esau despised his birthright. So Jacob and Esau were very different people.
Jacob e Isaac eran dos personas diferentes.
They had different hobbies, and Rebekah loved Jacob more, but Isaac loved Esau more.
Ellos tenían diferentes formas de pasar el tiempo. Rebeca amó más a Jacob. La Biblia también dice que Isaac amó más a Esaú.
I don't know, maybe they didn't get along as good as other brothers because of this.
Tal vez los dos hermanos no se llevaban tan bien como otros hermanos a causa de esta diferencia o preferencia que hacían sus papás.
But we do see that when Esau goes to Jacob and asks for some food, there was something very wrong.
Se nota que no se llevaban bien porque cuando Esaú va a pedir la comida a su hermano, hay algo que está mal.
So, Esau's hungry, and he saw his brother's stew.
Esaú tenía hambre y vio el guiso de su hermano.
He thought, "Surely my brother will give me some of his food."
Él pensó, seguro mi hermano me va a dar algo de su comida.
So he asked him for his stew.
Así que le pidió por su guiso.
But Jacob also saw an opportunity to get what he wanted, and he said, "Sell me your birthright."
Así que Jacob también vio una oportunidad para sacar provecho de su hermano y le dijo, "Véndeme tu primogenitura."
If I was Esau, I would be like, "No way."
Si yo fuera Esaú, yo le diría, "No, de ninguna manera."
I would just try to get food some other way.
Trataría de encontrar comida de alguna otra manera.
And if I was Jacob, I wouldn't have asked for the birthright.
Y si yo fuera Jacob, no hubiese pedido por la primogenitura.
I mean, it's just a plate of food.
Es simplemente un plato de comida.
But the craziest thing is that Esau actually accepts.
La locura en este caso es que Esaú aceptó.
He didn't have to do that.
Él no tenía que hacerlo.
He could have given him something else.
Podía haberle dado alguna otra cosa.
Or he could have gone to his father.
O podía haber ido donde su papá.
Isaac was rich. Of course he would have given his favorite son some food.
Isaac era un hombre rico, así que de seguro le hubiese dado a su hijito preferido la mejor comida.
But Esau decided that in that moment, a plate of food.
Pero Esaú decidió que en ese momento, un plato de comida
was more important than birthright.
Era más importante que la primogenitura.
He was so consumed by his want for that food.
Él estaba muy consumido por su deseo de esa comida, de ese plato de comida.
That he didn't think about the repercussions that it would have.
Él no pensó en los resultados que esto iba a traer.
And because of this, Esau despised his birthright.
Y por esto es que Esaú despreció su primogenitura.
Because he regretted his decision.
Porque después él se arrepintió de esta decisión que tomó.
As anyone would.
Como cualquiera de nosotros nos hubiéramos arrepentido.
And Jacob knew he would do that.
Y Jacob sabía que esto iba a pasar.
That's why he made the bold proposition.
Es por eso que él hizo la proposición de este plato de comida.
that if he could just get Esau to swear under oath,
él sabía que si conseguía que Esaú hiciera este juramento,
Esau wouldn't be able to go back.
Esaú no iba a poder hacerse para atrás.
And it would be legal.
Y este juramento sería legal.
Neither of these two men did what was right.
Ninguno de estos dos hombres hicieron lo que era correcto.
One was blinded by his desire for something.
Uno estaba enceguecido por su deseo de conseguir algo.
And the other took advantage of his brother's moment of weakness.
El otro se aprovechó del momento de debilidad de su hermano.
The birthright meant that the firstborn got twice the inheritance than the other children.
Primogenitura quería decir que el hijo mayor recibía el doble que los demás hermanos.
Because he had two children.
Porque Isaac tenía dos hijos.
The land and all his inheritance would be divided in three.
La tierra y todo lo que él tenía, su herencia, iba a ser dividido en tres.
Two portions would go to the older and one to the younger.
Dos porciones iban a ir al hijo mayor, primogénito, y una al hijo menor.
But in this case, it was more than just land and wealth.
En este caso, era mucho más que simplemente la tierra y las riquezas.
The birthright also included God's blessing.
La primogenitura también incluía la bendición de Dios.
The promise God gave Abraham passed to Isaac.
La promesa que Dios le dio a Abraham y que se la pasó a Isaac.
This is a big deal.
Esto es algo muy importante, muy grande.
And not just for Jacob and Esau, but for their descendants.
Y no era importante solamente para Jacob y para Esaú, sino también para su descendencia.
Furthermore, this occasion led to a lot of friction between these two that continued for generations.
Además, este momento de dificultad causó muchos problemas a lo largo de su genealogía y continuó por muchas generaciones.
In this passage, the Bible also tells us how Esau came to be called Edom.
Este pasaje también nos explica cómo es que Esaú vino a ser también llamado Edom.
We later see that in the Bible there is a group of people called Edomites.
En la Biblia también veremos más adelante que hay un grupo de gente que se llamaron los Edomitas.
They were Esau's descendants.
Ellos fueron la descendencia de Esaú.
They didn't always get along with the Israelites.
Y ellos no se llevaban bien con los israelitas.
But they didn't also fare as well as the Israelites.
Pero tampoco les fue bien como a los israelitas.
Before the Romans got to conquer Israel,
antes de que los romanos llegaran a Israel a conquistarles,
the Edomites were completely absorbed by other nations.
Los Edomitas fueron absorbidos por otras naciones,
including the Israelites,
incluyendo Israel.
So that was the end of them.
Y ese fue el final de los Edomitas.
How could God give someone his blessing?
¿Cómo podría Dios dar su bendición a alguien
that acquired it by cheating?
Que recibió esta bendición engañando.
How is that right?
¿Cómo eso va a estar bien?
God had to deal with Jacob.
Dios tuvo que tratar con Jacob.
Jacob had to flee from his brother.
Jacob tuvo que huir de su hermano.
After he stole Isaac's blessing from Esau.
Después de que Jacob robó la bendición de Esaú.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. He had to run away from his brother when he stole Esau's blessing. So for 20 years, God deals with him.
Así que por 20 años, Dios trató con Jacob.
And he had a life-changing encounter with God.
Y Jacob tuvo un encuentro que cambió su vida, un encuentro con Dios que cambió su vida.
He even changed his name.
Aún le cambió el nombre.
So, how does this apply to us today?
¿Cómo aplica esto a nosotros hoy?
We are all brothers and sisters in Christ.
Todos nosotros somos hermanos y hermanas en Cristo.
So let's not take advantage of each other.
Así que no debemos de tomar ventaja, no debemos de aprovecharnos el uno del otro.
We shouldn't take advantage of anyone, whether we know them or not.
Nosotros no debemos de tomar ventaja o aprovecharnos de nadie, ya sea que los conozcamos o no.
We shouldn't take advantage of the system either.
Tampoco debemos de tomar ventaja o aprovecharnos del sistema tampoco.
We can't use the government to get what we want.
Tampoco debemos aprovechar del gobierno para conseguir lo que queremos.
We could be hurting other people who really need the government's help.
Podríamos estar perjudicando a otras personas que verdaderamente necesitan de la ayuda del gobierno.
God wouldn't want us to do that.
Dios no querría que nosotros hagamos algo así.
Furthermore, we do have an inheritance.
Además, nosotros sí tenemos una herencia.
Not just from our parents.
No solamente la herencia de nuestros padres, que nos dejaron nuestros padres.
Romans 8:17 says,
Romanos 8:17 dice,
Now if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ, if indeed we share in his suffering, in order that we may also share in his glory.
Y si somos hijos, somos herederos, herederos de Dios y co-herederos con Cristo. Pues si ahora sufrimos con él, también tendremos parte con él en su gloria. Aleluya.
Our inheritance is eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Nuestra herencia es vida eterna a través de Cristo Jesús. Aleluya.
But we must be careful not to give it up.
Pero nosotros debemos de tener mucho cuidado de no renunciar a esta herencia.
For anything.
Por ninguna causa.
Even $1,000,000.
Y aún si fuera $1,000,000.
It's like a plate of food compared with eternal life.
Es como un plato de comida comparado a la vida eterna.
Amen.
Eternal life is something that lasts forever.
La vida eterna es algo que dura por siempre y para siempre.
It's eternal.
Es eterna.
What else lasts forever?
¿Qué más dura para siempre?
And decides where you will spend eternity.
Además, ¿dónde vas a pasar la eternidad?
Sometimes,
a veces,
just to be accepted.
Simplemente para ser aceptados.
We renounce our Christian morals and values.
Nosotros renunciamos a nuestros valores y principios cristianos.
Amen.
Or maybe we cheat our way to wealth.
O tal vez engañamos para conseguir riquezas.
This sounds a lot like what Esau did.
Esto se parece a lo que hizo Esaú.
Being blinded by a temporary desire.
Estar cegados por un deseo temporal.
And it had lasting consequences.
Y tuvo consecuencias que duraron por mucho tiempo.
In the General Conference of the United Methodist Church.
En la Conferencia General de la Iglesia Metodista.
The Liberian delegate said this.
Los delegados de Liberia dijeron esto.
Concerning the vote,
que tenía que ver con un voto,
on whether or not,
acerca de,
to accept people of different sexual orientations as ministers.
Era en cuanto a aceptar que personas de diferentes preferencias sexuales fueran ministros, fueran aceptados como ministros.
We get by on far less than most Americans do.
El delegado dijo, nosotros sobrevivimos con mucho menos que ustedes.
We know how to do it.
Nosotros sabemos cómo hacerlo.
I'm not sure you do.
No estoy seguro si ustedes saben cómo hacerlo.
So if anyone,
así que si hay alguien,
is so naive or condescending,
que fuera tan ignorante,
as to think,
como para pensar,
We would sell our birthright in Jesus Christ
para pensar que vamos a vender nuestra primogenitura en Cristo Jesús
for American dollars.
Por dólares americanos.
They are mistaken.
Ellos están equivocados.
Let's not do what Jacob or Esau did.
No hagamos lo que hicieron Jacob o Esaú.
We have something that we cannot give up.
Tenemos algo a lo que no debemos renunciar.
And there are things in life that you have to work to get. You can't cheat.
Hay algunas cosas en la vida por las que debemos de trabajar y no podemos engañar. Amén. En las lecciones que hemos estado estudiando, during the lessons that we have been having, Dios nos está llevando a entender que hay cosas que hemos estado haciendo mal. God has been showing us things that we have been doing wrong as Christian believers.
Amen.
Y lo hermoso de estar ante la presencia de Dios es que podemos pedir perdón.
Amen.
The wonderful thing about being in the presence of God is that we have the opportunity to repent and ask God to forgive us.
Amen.
Si hay alguna persona que se ha vendido por un plato de lentejas, if there is anybody that sold his birthright or her birthright for a plate of lentils, a bowl of lentils, este es el momento para pedir perdón. This is the moment to ask God to forgive us. Tratamos de tomar ventaja de oportunidades que pensamos que está bien, pero ¿saben qué? Nos olvidamos de preguntarle al Señor.
Amen.
¿Es esto lo que tú quieres?
Amen.
We try to take advantage, or we think we're taking advantage of a great opportunity, but are we asking God if that is right, or if that is something He wants us to do?
Amen.
Este es nuestro momento de pedir perdón, arrepentirnos y hacer un compromiso de ser personas que vamos a vivir con integridad cristiana.
Aleluya.
This is our opportunity to ask God to forgive us, to repent, and to make a new commitment to live in integrity, Christian integrity.
Dear Heavenly Father, we want to ask you this tonight, this evening, to please take our hearts. Show us, Lord, what's wrong with us. Show us our errors, Lord. Lord, if we have taken for granted salvation, as my daughter Mary brought it here, salvation as the inheritance through Jesus Christ. We cannot, we ought to be fighting for that. We cannot sell it for a plate of, for a bowl of lentils, for a bowl of food, metaphorically speaking. We can't sell it for anything. It's priceless, Lord. Lord, in today's lesson, we learned that we ought not to behave like Jacob did, like Esau did, taking advantage of one another. Lord, please help us walk in your ways. Help us proceed exactly how you want us to proceed. May we consult you in every which way we do, in every which direction and decision that we make. Father, we're here to tell you that all our trust, all our faith is in you. Increase our faith tonight, Lord.
Yes.
Increase our faith by the infilling of the Holy Spirit in us. Increase our faith. The only focus that we ought to have right now is you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Is you.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we proclaim you are the giver of life. Peter said, who shall we go to? Peter said to Jesus, who shall we go to? There's only life in you. There's only words of life in you. So tonight, we reconfirm our commitment of walking in your blessed ways.
Yes, Lord.
Father, for everything that you do. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.